But the stock had that little mark in it. It's 220 grit paper. Doing some quick sanding. Took the mark right out. There's a couple of marks I don't want to lose. You can tell them. Whoever had this gun before me, or whoever had it, whenever. Little notches right here. So seven little notches. And the history of this gun, I know it came from up north, Vermont area. Probably a good deer hunting gun. Just giving everything a nice little light sanding. I'm not even going to wipe it down. I'm going to keep a little bit of dust on it. And I'm going to use a little tung oil and rub that in by hand. What I do is I use the oil and a little bit of dust, sawdust that's on there, almost like a filler. And after that, after it dries, it's going to take a while to dry too. This is 100% tung oil. Take a couple days. After it dries, I use a little bit of wax to really seal it. Use your fingers, warm up the wood, warm up the oil. To me, that's the best way to rub it in. I might even hit it again with... last time I hit it with 220, I might hit it with 400 grain sandpaper. Just see how this wood looks after I rub this in. I'll let it sit for a while. Because I have a little bit of notches and dings and stuff like that, but to me that's all character. It's 100 years old, so it's going to have something. Set that aside. Put the forearm. That. So I'll set these off to the side, let them dry, and take another look at them. I'm going to do another quick little sanding. I'll use 400 grit then, a little bit of oil on it, kind of work it in. I'm going to use tung oil. You always squeeze the excess air out. Helps preserve it. I'll let that dry. I'm going to finish cleaning up all my parts. All I do is I spray them down with some CLP. Or let them sit there, or spray them down earlier and let them soak for a little bit. If I find anything a little too rough, sometimes I'll just get a brass brush and rub down real quick. Just bring separate. Should get all the nice, all the debris out of it. Pushing this trigger mechanism. My hammer. Oh, screws, I wipe down real quick. Make sure you put them back the way you took them out. I'll take them off the other cloth I have. Make sure I don't get them mixed up. This gave me some trouble getting out. It's a little gritty right here. Bolt. I'm not going to do much to it. I don't want to take too much of it apart. Just make sure the hammer, make sure your, you know, your firing pin shakes along. It's nice and free in there. A little bit of grit down here I'm just going to scrape off. I think that looks nice. Try to always wipe off a lot, especially the excess oil around the bolt. Don't really want to get anything really into the firing pin area. Gunk can build up on it. So I just try to wipe everything clean. Here's the firing pin railing. It's nice and free. And then when I reassemble it, I put a nice little bit of grease on it. A little bit of oil, not too much. A little bit of gunk right here. That's better. follower. Very clean that up. Your block. That's basically it for the cleaning. Alright, scrub this out. Spray it down, scrub it out. Get a little brushing inside. That's pretty much it. Wait for the stock to dry a little more and work on that more, but I might put some of it back together. Watch.